New York exhibition in Grand Central Station. Hurricane Sandy supposedly did this. This is in Vanderbilt Hall. They always have nice, cool exhibits. This is New York. History of New York. An amazing place. An amazing place. But a place of a lot of food, a lot of power through this city. Contributed to the city and pulled a lot of powerful energy from the city. I remember them building this, Hudson Yards, the 7 train goes there. Empire State Building always will have a spot on this earth. Amazing city. It has a history. We're almost at, look at this. Forward to city, drop dead. Vows he'll veto any bailout. Abe Carey Ripstand, stock skid, Dow down 12. That's it. There was a cool video with Ruby Dee over here. I don't know if they're going to show her again. Monitor 2.
In 2012, and our region was ill prepared for it.
I don't know. It's an amazing city. From what I read, this train station was built by Cornelius Vanderbilt, and it was saved by Jacqueline Kennedy Onassis. For New York City, it is a place apart. There is not its match in the other country in the world. As for New York City, it is a place apart. There is not its match in any other country in the world. Suppose you said by Pearl S. Buck. This is amazing. History of building of New York, planning, urban planning. I think my brother Eric would find this interesting, and so would Carl. This is an amazing place. It's amazing. I didn't realize this was here. It is amazing. New York City. Here for Hurricane Sandy. Montauk is a very beautiful area. I didn't see what damage it did. It's in Long Island. People should come here and check this out. I remember in Bruce Springsteen's autobiography, he lived in Freehold, New Jersey. He said that they were just 100 miles away from New York, and none of them have ever been to New York. The people he knew, he never been there, and nobody he and his family and friends knew ever been to New York City. Unsurprisingly, Bruce Springsteen would contribute to New York, as would Duke Ellington, Count Basie, Billie Holiday, John Hammond, Ahmet Ertegun, Atlantic Records, Harlem. Harlem, of course. It's almost impossible not to mention Harlem. It's amazing. I remember I first arrived here in 1978. Can't get over Empire State Building. I'm never gonna get tired of the Empire State Building. An amazing city. They're trying to connect Long Island to Grand Central. The trains are supposed to connect before this year's over. It said towards the end of the year. People should come and check this out. What's your vision of New York's future? People should come and check this out. What is the Regional Plan Association? New York will never appear as we picture it. Our only hope is that the lines we have drawn will inspire the citizens to express themselves with a greater love of order and a higher sense of beauty in the building of the city. It's amazing. I've been to Tokyo, very powerful city. Very. This is New York, Grand Central. Grand Central Station. All of this would be an office building if Jackie Kennedy Onassis did not spare it. I heard this girl say this is bigger, this train station is bigger than their airport. Entertaining, one of my favorite groups took their name from this place, Grand Central Station. This is Grand Central Station. Over here is the Apple Store. The Jordan Steakhouse was on the right, but it closed and never reopened. On the right was the restaurant. This is how you get to Irvington, New York, where Madam C.J. Walker's house is located. Catch the train here to Yale. Go here to New Haven. Grand Central Station. The Jordan Steakhouse was right on the right there. That was the Jordan Steakhouse in the old days. It is simply amazing. What if Billy Joel says he's gonna take a ride on that Hudson River line? He's in a New York state of mind. It's an awesome song. Awesome. It's an Sinatra made his mark here. Nat King Cole made his mark here. Jack Johnson made his mark here. Joe Frazier and Muhammad Ali made their mark here. By the grace of Allah, I made my mark here. 1978. That is when I first pulled power from this city. And that power has been in me since. I was what's the word when you hide your life or you hide your passion and your capability and your inspiration? I did that before. I'll never do that again, Allah willing. You don't hide what inspires you. You don't hire power like that. And this is just one place. This is just one place. Excuse me, sir. This is just one place. New York. That's a Charlie brand. It's a Charlie brand. Tomorrow's a Saturday. That's for the Halloween people. That's for the Halloween. There was a Junior's. They must have closed it, but there was a Junior's over here. This is still Grand Central Station. I remember that little girl, so what that young lady said, this is larger than their airport. This train station. I didn't realize this museum was open, or this store was open. I think I'm come return here. You see, this is one of the main hats. Businessmen don't even wear hats anymore in New York like they did in the old days. That hat will always be in New York because they're always building something. Always building something in New York. You go down here, the dining concourse, but Grand Central Station is how you get to Yale, New Haven. It's also how you get to the Irvington, New York, where Madam J. Walker's beautiful mansion is. It's up on a hill. Grand Central Station is also where you get to Hartsdale, where Malcolm X is buried in Ferncliff Cemetery. It was better than this before the pandemic. These places weren't closed like this. These places weren't like this, shut down. The place was alive, man. This place was really something, man. It was like a party. If it's raining or snowing, this is where you want to be. If it's pouring down, raining, snowing, this is where you want to be. They need to make the lights brighter in this place. Their restaurant is named Cipriani. Let me see, no, that's an oyster bar. The place is huge. This is where this young lady saw this area from up here, and she said that it's larger. In that airport, that's oyster bar. I thought this was Cipriani's, unless Cipriani's moved across the street. Yeah, this place, before the pandemic, this place was jumping. This place was jumping. There was a Junior's down here, a Junior's upstairs. Magnolia Bakery, It's just a lower level. Keep your ears open when you're traveling by train here. You don't want to miss your train getting caught up in the noise. Be glad when this place turns to its original glory. There's Magnolias. This place never returns. They had a loyal following before the pandemic, but they never returned. The Magnolia Bakery is at Rockefeller Center on 6th Avenue or Avenue of the Americas. That's where the main one is located. Here's more of New York, an amazing city. Well, they opened this, it was closed for a while. There's a flat iron building. This is on 72nd Street. Beautiful. It was better than this before the pandemic. Much better. Landmark City. Much better than this. I miss New York. To old New York. As I said, I didn't first fall in love with New York. First time I fell in love with New York, I was never here. You might can thank Batman for that. We knew Gotham City was New York. This, I've heard this fan of comic books giving a tour. He mentioned how the Joker and his the Penguin, I believe it was Catwoman, the Riddler, they went over to the UN and went to the Security Council and zapped everybody with some type of ray gun that turned them into powder. This is a lower level. Look how big it is. It was very exciting before the pandemic. This is a message people need to see. Metro North Railroad, we're hiring. Metro North is hiring skilled craft workers. This is what keeps New York going. It's an amazing place. It's an amazing place. Best lobster roll. They had one of these on 23rd Street. I didn't realize there was more than one donut plant. I didn't realize there was more than one. Look at this, man. It's a shame these. It's a shame this place is like this. Before the pandemic, this entire place was alive with people. Yeah. through here, this is where the new skyscraper, One Vanderbilt, place is located. But I want to go outside. Grand Central Terminal. See, they don't call it Grand Central Station. They call it Grand Central Terminal. That's the proper name for it. Grand Central Station would be the post office. Grand Central Station is the United States Post Office. Adjacent to this institution, it's on Lexington. But we thank Larry Graham for coming up with Graham Central Station. This is what they call it. This is what they're called. Yeah, you can go inside it. That place, One Vanderbilt. They're calling it the Summit.
Where's my desk? That was on my chair.
No, wait, but it wasn't on a roll chair. It wasn't on a desk.
I saw a whole bunch of people like that.
Reimagine. Reimagine wonder. Reimagine wonder. I don't want to go into the subway. Yeah, I don't want to go into the subway. I'm going to go through here and go out the old-fashioned way. Don't worry if this battery dies down. I am prepared. That's how you keep these places looking nice and clean. I hope those workers know they appreciate it. If they didn't do all this, you see this looks like gold. If they didn't do all of this, place look like a slump. I appreciate those workers keeping this place looking like this. So I'm gonna go out the old way. Let me see. Grand Central, I never get tired. The restoration of Grand Central Terminal was driven by the vision, leadership, and passion of Peter Stengel, the first president of Metro North Railroad, and realized creativity, professionalism, and determination of architect John Bell and his team, Buyer Blender Bell, as well as the many dedicated employees of the Metro North Railroad and the MTA. Chairman and CEO MTA 1991-1995. Architect and founding partner. Engineering, vision, leadership, talent. It's amazing. I wanted to do this for a long time. These windows where these trains are going, you don't have to know a lot about traveling. Just tell the people where you're trying to go, where you're trying to get to. that help you? I'm gonna go out on the side where the Michael Jordan steakhouse was. This is called the West Balcony. You can get to Penn Station from here.
Just get somebody to get the
This is where the Michael Jordan Steakhouse is. Right here. They can put it back if they want, right?
Not yet.
Come on. I'm going out on the west side. It's a cool area over here. Harvard Club is over this way. The Yale Club. The Yale Club is right up there, up the street. The Harvard Club is over this way. Cornell, Penn. I can't remember seeing any other Ivy League clubs over here. I've been to the Penn Club, never been to Harvard Club. Okay, Grand Central. That's the old Pan Am building right there. Now they call it MetLife. That's the old Pan Am Airlines. That's their building. A guy told me in there, you can't take pictures in there. Yeah. That's what he told me. This is, see, can we get a good shot? Grand Central Station from the outside. There's the Chrysler Building. You had a very interesting story on Cornelius Vanderbilt. He loaned money. From what I read, he never borrowed it. I think he borrowed it one time in his life or whatever. But he didn't make it his business borrowing money. He loaned people money later on in business. But was a very disciplined businessman. Here's Grand Central Station, and it is grand. This is Grand Central Station.